Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in meteorology preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render exposition of Luke 10:1-25. After these things, our anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus, and not a lord, he set us free, appointed others 70 laborers also, and sent them two and two in pairs before his face into every city and place whither he himself would come. Therefore said he unto them, the harvest truly is great. That means he himself would come, mean that they went there to make the way, as John the Baptist did. So in his capacity, he sent them before his face, so he can visit them later on, to make the way straight. Therefore said he unto them, the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Beg and not pray, because we beg our Father. Ye, therefore, the Lord of the harvest is God, that he would send forth laborers into his harvest. Go your ways, behold, I send you forth as lambs among wolves. These psychic people, they are wolves, you know. Carry neither purse, no money, nor scrip, don't bother about any book, nor shoes, and salute no man by the way. That means, keep to yourself, you don't throw purse before swines. So you have to see the person which you talk to is sensible. And into whatsoever house ye enter, first say, peace be to this house. And if the Son of Peace be there, your peace shall rest upon it. If not, it shall turn to you again. And in the same house remain eating and drinking such thing as they give to you, for the laborer is worthy of his hire. Go not from house to house. That don't go, you know, that, oh, their food is good, I go there. Stay there wherever you have been humble. Don't disappoint your host. And into whatsoever city ye enter, and they receive you, eat such things as are set before you. And heal the sick that are therein, and say unto them, the royal kingdom of God is come nigh unto you. But into whatsoever city ye enter, and they receive you not, go your ways out into the streets of the same, and say, even the very dust of your city, which cleaveth on us, we do wipe off against you, notwithstanding be you sure of this, that the royal kingdom of God is come nigh unto you. So that means that just shake the very dust of that town, as Christ Jesus did in the where the he made 2,000 swine to go into the lake. He shook the very dust of that and left the place. But I say unto you, that it shall be more tolerable in that day for Sodom than for that city. Sodom and Gomorrah people, they were sinners. But those people who do not take the word of God, they are blasphemers. Blasphemy is more serious than sin. Woe unto thee, Chorazin! Woe unto thee, Bethsaida! For if the mighty works had been done in Tyre and Sidon, which have been done in you, they had a great while ago repented, sitting in sackcloth and ashes. But it shall be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon at the judgment than for you. And thou, Capernaum, which art exalted to heaven, shalt be thrust down to hell. He that heareth you heareth me, and he that despiseth you despiseth me, and he that despiseth me despiseth him that sent me, that means God. And the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, no, he was not Lord, he was brother to them. He's saying, brother, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name. And he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning falls from heaven. And so he said, you know, he has the control over the Satan. And so as the lightning falls from the sky, behold, I give unto you power to tread down serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. You remember in America they are dancing with snakes in their hands, so they believe in Christ Jesus. And so that is going extreme. Here is symbolic. Notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirit are subject unto you. But that means in Christ Jesus, all the spirits are subject to them because he gave the authority to them. But rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven, because you are predestined of God to serve him. Unless you are predestined, you can't preach gospel. So this is received by grace of God. In that hour Jesus rejoiced in spirit and said, I thank thee, O Father God, Lord of heaven and earth, our Lord of the whole creation, that thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, so it seemed good in thy sight. Now these things which Christ Jesus came to deliver, they were hid from the general public. This is called oral Torah. The rabbi used to have it, and that too not as good as Christ Jesus gave them. So that was a limited. And here Christ Jesus come, the very fountain of oral Torah, and he then gave them all the mysteries of God that was kept secret from the general public. All things are delivered to me of my Father, and no more knoweth who the Son is but the Father. Only Father knows the value of his Son. You don't seek praises from the people. You leave it to our Father. We came to glorify our Father, not to glorify ourselves as the rabbi used to do, who put on long clothes, our bishop and popes, and who the Father is but the Son, and he to whom the Son will reveal him. Only the Son knows that who is the Father and what is his value. And he turned him unto his laborers and privately, blessed are the eyes which see the things that ye see, because they are very fortunate to have. For I tell you that many prophets and kings have desired to see these things which ye see and have not seen them, and to hear those things which ye hear and not heard them. So this Christ Jesus comes in this dark age when the rabbis had become corrupt. So he delivers the very, he being the very source of oral Torah, So he delivers the secrets